My notes for this thing are like insane. Anyway, let's talk about it. Is Bridgerton the new Game of Thrones? Shows that could be the next Game of Thrones. What happened to shows that were supposed to become the next Game of Thrones?
These shows are battling to be the next Game of Thrones.
This new series is being called the New Game of Thrones. The HBO's new Game of Thrones. Do you guys think Hollywood is obsessed with Game of Thrones? Like, be honest.
Nor.
Hi, this is Coney. Welcome or welcome back. Remember, your only goal and wish in life is to like, subscribe, hit the bell, and comment something down below. You know, like, for me, please. So, let's get into it. Chapter 2. Cultural impact. Fashion. You know, the girlies were obsessed with Game of Thrones hairstyles. You know, if you look up, Sansa Stark hairstyles, or how to do Arya Stark's hairstyles, or Daenerys braid tutorial. You know, this thing made or break YouTubers' careers, basically. You know, the Game of Thrones hairstyles. The girlies were obsessed with them. And if you see, like, somebody with 8 crisscrossing braids, you would be like, is this a Game of Thrones recreation? Like, do be honest. And it usually is. You know, on the other side, we do have Bridgerton dresses. Every girl that ever wears an Empire waistline must be inspired by Bridgerton. There is literally no other way in the world. This is sarcasm, by the way. But like, if you do see an Empire waistline, you're like, oh, that's Bridgerton, babes. Edwardian fashion is in. Because, you know, the Bridgerton siblings wear it, so I should wear it too. One thing both of the shows did really well was understanding how color palettes work. For example, in Bridgerton, you do have the Bridgerton blue, you do have the Featherington yellow, and the Featherington orange, and the Featherington pink. Although, you know, like, nobody really tries to emulate the Featheringtons because, like, they are usually considered, like, literally so tacky. But, like, everybody wants to be, like, a Bridgerton girl, like, you know, like, we're Bridgerton blue. And, you know, I think Penelope's new glow-up is gonna get, like, a lot of girls being like, oh, I wanna wear, Penelope green. And, like, you know, Game of Thrones did have the Lannister red, and did have the Targaryen blue, and it did have the Targaryen silver, and, you know, the hair being, like, bleach blonde and the violet eyes, and they did have, you know, like, the dresses and the Queen of the North, you know, like, all that stuff. It was lowkey insane, you know, seeing it in real time. But it was, like, really interesting because, like, you know, both these shows, like, really played the game really well. And they personally ate. Good for them. 2. Music. I got the names of both the Game of Thrones composer and the Bridgerton composer written down, and I'm going to butcher both horribly, so be prepared. But I promise it's not out of, you know, like, malice. Because I know, Jesus, I know how horrible it is for somebody to mispronounce your name. I am Greek, everybody mispronounces my name. But, like, I did Google how to pronounce both of them, and it did not help. So, you got, Ramin Djawadi, Ramin Djawadi, I do not know, and I'm terribly sorry about this, and he did the Game of Thrones soundtrack, and you got Chris Bowers, who knows, who did the Bridgerton soundtrack. And both of them are really great at what they do, and I feel really bad for not saying their names correctly. But, like, if you know how to say their names, like, honestly, do educate me in the comments, because like I really won't say both of these names correctly. Sorry. And you know, they both did such a great job with it. You know, you just have to hear, you know, I'm like so musically gifted. That was karma, anyway. And you immediately recognize it's Game of Thrones. Or, I mean, like, you know, the most iconic Bridgerton song is this cover of Taylor Swift's Wildest Dreams. But, you know, again, this is peak Bridgerton. And I think this is one of the reasons why Taylor Swift made the comeback that she did. But that's, like, another reason for another story. But, like, you do have, like, for Game of Thrones, I mean, I think you've definitely seen, you grew up on the internet, otherwise you would not be watching this. You have seen, like, all of the edits that, like, put Game of Thrones music over literally anything. And, I mean, the girlies and the boyies are, like, going crazy about Bridgerton soundtrack. Like, they do be having a guy playing the viola of a cover of, I don't know, Plastic by Britney Spears. And they would be like, oh, it's so Bridgerton soundtrack. Girl, it's like a guy playing a viola. But, I mean, it does have this insane cultural impact, and, like, they both slayed for that, honestly. Chapter 3. Octave's first big thing, mostly. So, you know, it might be a me problem, but for most of the actors, it was the first time that I had ever seen them, like, on screen. And I think for them it was also, like, the first big thing, you know? Mostly because there were also a lot of younger actors. For example, like, in Game of Thrones, you do have the Stark children that were obviously, you know, like, children, so they had not acted before. And in Bridgerton, you have the two youngest siblings, which, you know, you see them grow up in the show, and it's insane how much they've grown up. I think they were my children at this point. Like, little Gregory going from this to this? It's insane! This is my son! Anyway, But, like, it will also, like, this is kind of a double-edged knife. I don't know why I have this hair thing on me. Yeah, anyway, I think it's like a double-edged knife because I did read an interview with Luke Newton, the guy, you know, who, the actor who plays Colin Bridgerton. And this is not a direct quote, it's more of a paraphrasing, but I think I will put the direct quote somewhere. That he said that, like, you know, in 5 to 10 years, I don't want to just be, you know, older Colin Bridgerton. I do want to be known for other things. And, you know, that is completely valid. And, you know, you do see this a lot with actors that have the first big break in something huge. You know, like, think the Chronicles of Narnia kids. You know, like, Anna Popwell will always be Susan Pevensey for me. And honestly, I still am obsessed with Susan Pevensey. But that is another topic for another time. I'm getting carried away. Like, I think that the actors can't really run away from it. Like, at least at this point. You know, like, Phoebe de Noir. Is that correct? I don't think it is. I am terribly sorry for everybody whose name I actually butchered in this. But, you know, like, every time the poor woman posts anything on Instagram, you know, I mean, I think, you know, this feature would be, like, just in case, if you're less online than me, which is, like, honestly possible. Like, there is this new comment that allows users to comment with a GIF on Instagram. GIF, you know, like, whatever. And every time she posts something, the comments are full of GIFs. I refuse to say GIF. I know it's the correct way to say it, but I refuse to say GIF. It's so not correct. like, the entire conversation is filled with gifs of one of the later episodes where she's in one of the later episodes where she is like placating to the Duke, and she's like, "Your Grace, it is everywhere. Poor woman cannot escape it. It's crazy." Anyway, so chapter 3, clear goal and long journey. So in Game of Thrones, you do have the clear goal of winning the Iron Throne. In Bridgerton, you have the clear goal of getting married. And I know it is like two drastically different scales, like, you know, getting the throne and getting married, you know, like, there is some difference there. But, you know, you in Game of Thrones, you do have, for example, Cersei, that has been bred her entire life just to rule over Westeros. And in Bridgerton, you have Daphne Bridgerton, who has been bred her whole entire life to, you know, get married to the best possible match that she can find. So, you know, for those two women, like, those things have the exact same weight. Like, it's the most important thing that they will ever do in their lives. And coincidentally, they do have the same amount of seasons. You know, Game of Thrones has 8 seasons, although we don't really talk about the last one, but it is there. And, you know, Bridgerton also has 8 books, you know, one for each sibling. And, you know, there is also the Queen Charlotte spin-off, but I don't count this because it's like, you know, the House of the Dragon spin-off. Also, do you guys think Queen Charlotte is going to die in season 3 of Bridgerton? Because, like, I think it's going to happen. So, like, this is obviously non-spoilers because the season has not come out yet as of, you know, today. Or do we have any promotional material saying so? But I really think she's going to die, you know, based on historical evidence. So, like, do drop a comment if you think Queen Charlotte is going to die in season 3 of Bridgerton. Anyway, yeah. So, you know, both shows are based on books, which have really dedicated followings. Let me say that. I have not read the Bridgerton books yet. Because I honestly don't want any spoilers, which is, like, low-key pathetic. Like, you don't want spoilers for Bridgerton. But, like, I'm a Bridgerton girlie, so it is not a crime. I know who they're going to marry, because, like, I've seen people spoil it online. But, like, I don't want to see, you know, any of the plot twists. You know, like, how in book 3... everybody has been saying something about a mirror. I mean, I do know what happens in the mirror because, like, everybody has been talking about this. But, like, what is happening with, like, the blonde guy that we got the promo for, you know, the other day? I don't know, and I don't wish to know, you know, I want to have a suspense. But I did read the Game of Thrones books when I was in middle school. Can you imagine? I was like 12, reading about people being, you know, of things that do not agree with the YouTube guidelines happening to them, you know, like both good and bad. And it was like, huh? You know, that meme with the cat that goes like, huh? That was me, age 12, reading about a guy being like pulled by horses and, like, you know, oh my god, that was an experience. But I do remember it was, I think it was a Feast for Crows. I don't remember which one it was, but it was this impossibly long book that relatively nothing was happening. It was like 800 pages, and, you know, like, Jaime Lannister was riding on a horse. His chapters were like him riding on a horse, him stopping on a tavern, him riding on a horse. And, like, they were like 2 chapters with the guys from the Sea Kingdom. I don't remember what it was called because it has literally been so long. The guys that had, like, you know, a squid up their banner, and they had, like, you know, the witch. And it was like the most insane things that you could ever possibly imagine. And it was like three chapters throughout the whole book. The rest of it was like Jamie riding a horse. And I was like, oh my god, when is this going to end? Because it was part one of, you know, an equally long part two. And I was like, oh my god. Anyway, yeah, that did help me, you know, like, manage my expectations, like, in life. But, oh my god, it was insane. Anyway, chapter four is up. Do you, like, live under a rock? LOL. You know, one thing with both of the series is you might have not watched it, but you have certainly heard about it. I mean, like, you have seen pictures, you do have seen the actors, like, I confused the name with the actress, I'm terribly sorry. Sophie Turner will forever be, you know, the Queen of the North. Like, it is all over her Instagram posts, like in the comments, not herself, but, you know. You know, when her divorce happened, everybody was like, we rally with the Queen in the North, you know, we're like, yeah. Kind of cringe, but also, like, really sweet, if you ask me. And I mean, you have heard of the phrase, the things I do for love, which is from Game of Thrones. Or you have heard, or in my case, like, you know, by heart, the whole monologue, but I am living for India, and it's not far enough. Do you think there is a corner on this earth that you could go to, far away from me, to free me from this torment? I am a gentleman. My father raised me to act with honor, and this honor is hanging by a thread that grows even more precarious with every moment I spend in your presence. You are the bane of my existence and the object of all of my desires. The Anthony Bridgerton monologue, like, lives in my head, like, run through. And honestly, Bridgerton is the only series I have ever rewatched in my whole entire life. I'm not a rewatcher. Sorry. I don't rewatch series. I do rewatch movies. But, like, it does have to be either the most stupid movie on earth, so we can just, like, watch it and be like, haha, nice. Or it has to be, like, the most profound, emotional piece. Or it just, like, you know, like, because I don't know how it is like in the rest of the world, but like in Greece we do still have very prominent cable television that like you have like a couple of channels and you open it and you see what's playing. There are some movies that just, you know, keep playing on repeat. You know, for example, Ocean's like 11. I have seen it so many times. It's insane. But it's one of those movies that like, you know, the first time you watch it, you're like, oh! The second time you're watching it, you're like, ha. Nice. But yeah, as I was saying, I'm not a rewatcher, but Bridgerton is the only series I've rewatched ever in my life. And it's not even my favourite series. My favourite series is The Good Place. But I can't rewatch that, you know, in how much emotional turmoil I was when I finished The Good Place. Oh my god. If you have watched it, you know. But I was just like staring at the wall like this for like 10 minutes. Anyway, like, Bridgerton brings me such joy. I like kick my feet in the air and like giggle and be like, oh, Bridgerton, like, Anthony proposed to Kate thrice. Stupid ass man. I love stupid ass men in romantic comedies. Like, I was literally saying out loud, I was watching it with my mom the other day, which is kind of weird because, like, you know, Bridgerton does have, you know, stuff in it. We were like watching a chill episode and I turn to her and I go, like, look at this stupid ass man, like, he is so stupid, oh my god. And she was like, yeah he is. Also, like, as a final note, that do you live under a rock comment can also be expanded to merge. You have seen Game of Thrones merge, like, everywhere. And you have seen Bridgerton merch, whether you know it or not. This Is Bridgerton merch? This was from the Queen Charlotte ex coronavirus drop, like last year. Original written plural. I can't speak. Time for a like tea break. Because you know the tea is like hot, it's not the best thing, it's like lukewarm at best, but the tea is hot. Anyway, yeah. So this is Bridger merch. It was from the Queen Charlotte extra virus drop like last year. Original retail price was €70. I got it for €20 because it was like the third price reduction. Because like I don't think anybody's gonna pay like €70 for a Stradivirus ex Queen Charlotte merch. But it's like honestly such a pretty dress. I love it so much. It's only like downside is that it is so heavy and it has so like tiny little straps. It cannot support its own weight, so it keeps like, you know, pulling and tugging. So you do have opinion, but I mean like this is a small issue, you know. And also Bridgerton is keeps dropping like those insane collabs on Instagram. Like they do have a collab on milk, they do have a collab on coffee saucer. They do have a collab with some soaps and some biscuits, I think. And they do have a collab with wedding dresses, which is iconic, honestly. Like, getting married in a Bridgerton wedding dress. You know, it's like, get married like Daphne Bridgerton. Get married like Catherine Sharma. No, not Catherine. Cathani Sharma. Get married like Cathani Sharma. Get married like Queen Charlotte. I would love to get... Oh my god. Anyway, now that you have heard all about my future wedding planning, not that I'm in any position of wedding planning, but you know. Anyway, I do thank you for staying this long. Do you guys think Bridgerton is the new Game of Thrones? Like, do talk about it in the comments. I would love to hear people talk about it. And also, do you think Queen Charlotte will die? Like, also say that in the comments. I think she's going to die. I really think she's going to die because, like, they did her tribute before this season. And it was like, oh, how can we possibly find an heir? Heir? Yeah. What will happen if she is not here? Guys, I think it was foreshadowing. I can be for real. I think it was foreshadowing. I think she's going to die. And yeah. Like, you know, there will be this whole fanfare of, ooh, who will be the next queen? Or, like, king. I think it's a king, no? Oh, I'm not, like, familiar with British royalty succession lines, but, like... Anyway, I think it's a queen. No, I think it's a king that dies and leaves... I think it's Victoria. Yeah, I think it's Victoria in London afterwards. Yeah, I think it's Queen Victoria. Anyway, so yeah, we will see. I'll keep saying home, this is not like me. Anyway, so thank you very much for watching. Remember, your only goal in life is to like, subscribe, hit the bell and comment something down below. And I will see you guys soon. As Queen Charlotte says, sorrows, prayers. So kisses, kisses, bye.